In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and it was good. He made people in his image to look just like him. Men and women, he made them both. But then we rebelled against God and actually ran away from him and caused all of the brokenness that we see us. And ever since, we've been born blind. Well, God didn't want it to stay this way. So he actually had to kill an animal to cover their shame. And he made clothes for Adam and for Eve. And he covered their shame with the skins of the animal skin. And without the shedding of blood, there's no forgiveness of sins. But now that they're covered, they're okay. But they had these kids, Cain and Abel. And they both wanted to offer sacrifices to God. And they both brought what they had to God, but God accepted one of their sacrifices and not the other. So out of jealousy, Cain kills Abel. And we've got the first family dealing with all this brokenness. And this brokenness causes pain. And we do things to try to get out of that pain. Things that are wrong, and we do things that are right to try to get ourselves out of brokenness. They make us feel good for a while. But both of these things leave us stuck in brokenness. It's like a boomerang. We're just snapped back and totally stuck in all of this brokenness. And God sent some more prophets to point us in a direction. He sent Father Abraham. And Father Abraham had a son. And God told him to take that son and lay his son on the altar. And he was willing to do that. And he raised the knife to kill his son. And then God said, "Stop, you passed the test." And then he said, "Look, there's a ram stuck in the bushes. Kill the lamb instead of your son." And God provided the substitute. And then God used the prophet Moses to say, "Let my people go," to Pharaoh. And Pharaoh had 10 opportunities to let the people go, and they still wouldn't listen. So finally, God sent the death angel, and God told Moses that everybody that has the blood from the lamb on the door of their house, that the death angel would pass over and would not kill their family. And so Moses listened, and God's people listened, and they all put the blood of the lamb over their doorposts, and the death angel passed over. And then God's son shows up on the scene, and that's where this third circle comes into play. And John the Baptist, another one of God's prophets that he sent, he was the crazy one that was always out in the wilderness. And he said, "Look, this is the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world." And the religious leaders took Jesus and they nailed him to the cross. And he died and was buried. And then on the third day, he rose again, just like he said. And God looked down at his son and said, "Good job, son. I'm going to bring you back here to heaven with me and sit you down at the right hand of the throne of God in honor." And God crowned his son with honor. And it's King Jesus that changes everything for us. And although God doesn't cause all of this brokenness, it's our blindness that causes the brokenness. He gets blamed for it all the time. But he provided a way out. He sent his only son, Jesus, into the world. And Jesus wasn't like the first guy that he sent, that he made. He actually lived a perfect life, and he never did anything wrong. And although God doesn't cause this brokenness, he's so powerful, he can use it to bring us to the point where we turn to King Jesus. And when we surrender and say, "You know what? I did it. I was wrong. I'm sorry." When we surrender to King Jesus, it's King Jesus that makes us brand new. And so my question to you is, which of these two circles, if you had to choose between just these two circles, does your life feel more like right now? God's love and God's design, or are you stuck over here in this brokenness? There's no right or wrong answer. And then the second question that I have for you is, which of these three guys do you feel more like? Are you blind, running away from God's love and God's design? Or are you broken, kneeling down and crying out to God saying, "I did it, I was wrong, and I'm sorry"? Or has King Jesus made you brand new? And Jesus said, "Just like the Father sent me, so I send you. Deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me." Are you following Jesus, taking up your cross on mission for him? telling other blind people how they can become broken and how King Jesus can make them brand new? Which of these three guys are you? Blind, running away from God, broken, turning to God, or brand new, living on mission for God? And then the last question is, tell me your baptism story of how you were baptized, you identified with his death, going under the water, and his resurrection, coming up out of the water. Tell me your baptism story. This is three circles with a pathway to the prophets for a Muslim people group.